It's gonna be our fire stick lady. But yeah, but fire stick lady is getting a degree, yo. Yeah, in IT, so we so proud of her.
But that's good. All I know is
our IT situation.
Long as she keep the fire stick going, she can do whatever she wanna do.
Yeah.
So that's how I feel about that. But that's gonna be cool. Also, something weird happened on Bell reading the news today about the Krispy Kreme and Pandora Bread owners or with Panera Bread.
Mm-hmm.
Their family are from the Nazi era.
Yeah,
and I think they
were in the Nazis.
Were in the Nazis.
Man. I couldn't believe it. I thought you was lying.
And they actually, this is in the New York Post.
And then I saw their picture, and I'm like, yeah, sure looked like a German.
Yeah, and they
Nazi because so I lived there, so I could say it.
They actually say, yeah, they did.
They admitted.
They kind of wasn't apologetic about it.
That's the history,
and that's the weird thing about it.
Yeah,
so y'all messing with Panera Bread and Krispy Kreme.
It's just so much to protest.
Yeah, man.
So much.
But this is the age of awareness, and I think we're starting to see
that our dollars count. Yes, it does.
A lot of people are starting to realize what's going on.
Here for your evil ways.
So, you know,
glorifying evil things.
Everything's
evil
gonna,
things.
This is what it said. Age of Aquarius is the age of knowledge. So,
yes.
Starting
we're
now,
start dropping some.
That's why y'all start seeing a lot of the black people getting their stuff together, man. You see it all the time now. I've been saying it. I mean, now we still got a long way to go, of course, but I think we're figuring things out, which is, I love to see. You know what I'm saying? I love to see it. You know?
We all right.
Exactly. We're going to be all right. You know what I'm saying? But it's a lot of racism and stuff that's showing its head.
Coming to
but
the fore again.
We're going to always have it. You know what I'm saying? But, if you are, as the roster say, you know, you go to the human side of things. You know what I'm saying? Because humanity is first, you know what I'm saying? And then everything else falls in place. But you know we got to do that. What's your new music? Have you heard it?
I'm going to have to honestly say I haven't. Just for a simple fact that I'm born again. So, we have this great gospel station here, and they play amazing music. So, like, when I go to work, which I go every morning with hesitancy because I want to retire, but I go and I listen to that, and it just lifts up my spirit, and then I know things will be okay because I've already stayed right here. But honestly, no, I haven't heard any new stuff. Maybe I have and I think about it like that anymore.
She a little bit country, I'm a little bit rock and roll.
Yeah, that part.
I have been listening to a lot of music. I try to keep my ear.
So what's out?
I think hip hop wise, I've been listening to a whole lot of stuff. I've been listening to Rapsody stuff. Rapsody stuff is strong, man. I mean, it's really a big, while it's a black power movement, it's also a really black feminine power movement. Man. She speaks more so on the record.
Cool.
So it's kind of like one of them kind of deep type kind of records, which is dope because she can spit. And also, Pete Rock. And Sky Zoo, guy that rap album called Retropolitan. It's kind of like.
Don't you email Pete Rock a lot?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, that's my guy. That record is pretty dope. Got a lot of good stuff. My record of the year is Bandana. That's Madlib and Freddie Gibbs. I still think that's my personal record of the year. Definitely Little Brother record that came out. It's a renaissance in the Griselda boys. I mean, all the boys, Conway the Machine, Benny Butcher, they got a whole movement going on right now. That's what I'm feeling right now. So, pretty dope. So, on that note, any last words for the day?
Okay.
Or what, until our next podcast, which I think we're going to try to do this once a week. But, you know, and I'm also going to do a Keys for the City podcast coming up, which is just going to be about strictly what's going on for the week. I always have people come up to me like, what's going on, blah, blah, blah. And I kind of keep on touching on people, what's going on with little things. So I'm gonna do like a 15-minute podcast a weekly, and you're going to, it's going to be on the website, and you can go to it, and you can see what's going on.
Popping.
What's pop.
Yes.
So what's your last word?
I'm
going to
say I want to give my beloveds a shout out. Those are my children and grandkids and my mom. So when I say beloved, that's who I mean. Love you, and God bless, and hope to see you again soon.
And my shout out is going to be to everybody.
Because you're the mayor.
I just want everybody to pay attention to our
He's
podcast.
The mayor.
I want you to pay attention to what we're trying to do. The little quickie about the Fortnite thing. Fortnite thing is for everybody, y'all. It's the umbrella to more keys for the city and for podcasts and for production and for media and all kinds of things. But it's basically, if you don't, it's for, I'll put you on it. It's as simple as that. And it's a format to help people out. Just to steer traffic towards the website to possibly help you out. You have your own page and whatever. And if we approve it, you know, if it's dope enough. If not, we'll put you a link up there to whatever you're doing. So one way or another, you're still getting basically free promotion. If you go to Facebook, you go to North Carolina Hip Hop page. That is me. I'm the administrator of that page. And right now, we close to 1,500 people, which just been taking off as of late. I guess that's because of the renaissance of hip-hop music in North Carolina and out and about, you know, nationally and internationally as well. So, on that note, we're going to be out. And peace and love. Put God first.
Yes.
And we'll talk to you again next week on whatever we got on our mind. From now on, lipsticks and bullets down.
Peace.